Welcome back. It's only a few days until the big holiday and the end of the year. So let's take a look. This time we're going to be building up Mr. Norm's Supercharger funny car. Nice red Dodge Charger. Let's take a look at everything that's going to be in the box when you get yours. We will start off on the right side of the table this time. We've got this here. You might wonder what that is when you first open the box. If you haven't ever built one of these before, don't lose this. It's not scrap. It's not a tire. It is the blower drive belt for that big Hemi engine. So we'll be taking a look at that. We've got a set of two nice MH Racemaster tires that are two-piece. Excuse me. Two-piece tires, but they go together so easily and so well, you really don't notice once they're on the model. Nice white logos. We can sand those down, make them look more realistic. And a set of skinny Goodyear tires for the front. They are branded on there. We've got two chrome trees, one consisting of some very nice small detail parts like pulleys for the blower, steering wheel, blower top, moon tank, valve covers, some linkages, steering linkages. I like that the blower scoop is all one piece. Don't have to glue that one together. Don't have to repaint it. Some steering linkage. All small parts on there. On this one, we've got a nice offering of wheels and designs. And then we get into more of the links in the rear suspension. In the front suspension, I like that it's one piece. I hope that's going to help me out to align it. Blower parts front and rear, some small gauges, so a nice tree there, multiple wheels. I like that the manual mentions that. Note, we have included a variety of optional wheel styles to choose from. You can research old magazines or photos, or you may just choose a wheel style that will burn up the track. In other words, Polar Lights gets it. Just have fun. Nice set of glass, a little thick on there, but very clear. And each piece has a nice border molded into it so we can detail it. We'll do that on screen. We can outline the seal around the glass. And then the nice Mr. Norm's Charger decal set. On the bottom is the large white stripe. You can just make it out on camera. That's that white stripe for around the fenders, so you don't have to paint that on. You've got grille and taillight options, 69 split, 68 solid. We've got the scoops for the sides of the doors, and this molded in a, printed in a metallic tone, like the real thing, and that's silver. Nice looking set of decals all the way across, so you can decide what grille and what taillights you want to put on yours when you build it up. On the left side of the table, the rest is white styrene. Very nicely done for the interior. You can see that's even got braces molded into it. Parachute mount on the back of the car. We've got more interior and chassis pieces. I think this is what holds the nose up. The large webbing there. We got our tilt mechanism. You can see it's going to capture that in those parts back there, so the body can tilt up. All the bracing and supports and that nice off-white plastic, very easy to paint. Got our interior, some wheel backs, got our drag racing seat, got a nice separately molded harness instead of being molded in. That's very nice. Looks like a drive shaft support possibly. I don't know the name of all the parts, and it doesn't matter because I'm just going to have fun building a kit. We got our rear end on here, linkages, fire extinguisher, world's shortest drive shaft, parachute, some more supports. We got our roll cage parts, wheel backs. We've got the two sides to our frame, to our chassis there, you can see. Molded open locator holes. We'll have to try our hardest to align that straightly when we assemble it. Mirror pieces. On this one here, we've got our engine package, transmission, block halves, cylinder heads with detail molded into them. Got our intake, pan, oil pan, more interior, our front and back mounts for the engine, magneto, beautiful headers, all molded in one piece yet separate, so we can detail them. Even got the tips drilled out, molded out, but Yeah, very nicely done. I like that. That speeds up my work. And the charger body. Everyone knows that charger body. I was just watching old episodes of the Dukes. That would be cool if you wanted, if you didn't want to do Mr. Norm's. You got that 69 grill and taillight decal set. You could make a really sweet General Lee charger funny car. That'd be awesome. I don't have the 01 or the Confederate flag or the General Lee. I'm going to do Mr. Norm's because I like the box art and I've never done a Mr. Norm's car. But yeah, you definitely could. That just popped to mind while I was looking at the body. Nice. It's a heavy weight too. I like that. Nicely molded. Excellent work. I'm going to get to gluing mine together and I'll be right back. Welcome back. Now we've got everything assembled. The sub-assemblies before, I'm going to take it over to the painting area and throw color at it. So let's take a look at what we've put together, what I think of it, and everything so far. I am going to leave the rear suspension and the front suspension and axles off. I can attach those later. There's large enough mounting holes on the chassis to know where they go. And what I'm going to do is flat coat these metal parts. I don't want bright chrome parts. I want it as if it was, you know, a bar chrome moly steel welded together and stuff like that. So we don't want it super chrome. Same with everything on this tree. The valve covers, the steering links, the blower I'm going to remove, the blower scoop. That I'll leave chrome. But the linkages and stuff like that, I just want to do in a natural metal finish, which can be easily achieved using the techniques I will show. We've got the support, which is exactly what I thought it was. So that's cut off. We can get that painted separately, attach it later. We got our headers and our oil filters. We can get those painted up. Now the manual says black. If you want to do a more natural metal, whatever you decide, you go ahead, paint your model your way. The blower assembly, made out of four different parts. We got the center, the back, the pulley, the drive assembly, and the pulley. Glued all those together with super glue. I'm going to repaint that. But even if I didn't, it's very nice looking in a chrome unit if you want to leave it as is. Same with the moon tanks. Those are glued together from three pieces, each end and the cap. Those are nice looking. I'm going to get those painted up with a metallic colored paint. The rear wheels and the wheel backs, we have solid tires, so I can push the wheels in separately later. Those will be painted up a gold tone like they are on the box art, so that they're not a chrome tone. The front wheels on the box art are chrome. I'll just give them a black wash to tone it down a little bit, but I won't flat coat it because they do look very similar. Get that over here. Very similar to the box art. Those are pretty shiny in that picture. You can see the light glinting off of it and everything. So those I won't alter too much. We got a bunch of parts here. We got the rear brakes. We got header supports, drive shaft, parachute, and fire extinguisher. We can get all that sprayed with primer. We can cut them off. We can paint them by hand. We can do whatever we want with them, but we'll leave them there to get them painted. We got the mount for the parachute. I will put that with the blower parts and get that painted a metallic color. We got the chassis itself. It is pretty fettly to put together. You're going to end up probably with a tweak on it a little bit. You can work it out later when you attach the interior, which should hold it straight. Whoa! But it is pretty strong. As you can see, you can drop it and you'll just knock the motor loose. It does fit into two little grooves here in the front of the chassis. And that's how it looks with the engine installed. But that's our chassis as it is without the engine in it. All you really see is the chassis itself, the mounts, and what I used was model glue and then super glue over that to hold it tight. And I did glue in the oil filter mount, so that all I have to do is just glue on the two oil filters when I'm done. This will all get painted as one unit, and it'll be much stronger than if we tried to assemble it later. But you can see, I mean, it's sitting flat. You know, it's not, it's got a little bit of a tweak to it, but we'll see if we can work that out as we go. When we glue the engine in and when we glue this interior tub in, we'll see if we can work even that little bit out. The engine itself, we got our engine mounts, cylinder heads, mount for the blower. I glued the magneto in because I want it to hold fast. Got our two pulleys. Since we've got that belt we have to stretch over, I really want to glue stuff in early so that it's solid. And then we can work on that belt, getting that belt on. We got our starter in place, transmission and pan and oil pan. It's a nice looking assembly, very large, big block engine there. On our interior, and we'll push this stuff out of the way. I always like to assemble the roll cage on top of my interior. You can see what it looks like, and then we have a very sturdy assembly. Then I just remove it. You can see that nice roll cage all set up, ready to be installed. We can get this painted. We can attach our steering and all that to it later. They've got very large locator holes for the steering box and all that stuff. So that I didn't need to attach at this point. I can do that later. Got the interior together, glued the back wall of the interior on so that it's solid. These five holes here are where our roll cage mounts. Our seat goes there. Shifter, I already glued the gas pedal in. I don't want to chrome anyways. I can touch it with some silver paint. We got our seat and our harness, which is awesome. I can get those painted and then attach the harness separately. Don't have to paint it on the seat. That's going to look pretty nice. And then we will get to the largest assembly of the car. And I don't want to forget the rear end there. That will go in once we attach the rear suspension. We can slide it in. Is our body with the interior. Now, there is a bulkhead back here. This is what we'll clip onto this part of the chassis so that the body can clamshell up. There is no locator marks. The manual just says rear bulkhead goes, you know, back there. What you want to do first is assemble your entire interior piece. You want to make sure your interior piece lines up with the cutout for the blower in the front of the body and the back window. Once you know where that is, that will tell you where to put the rear bulkhead. The rear bulkhead notches into that interior. Then go ahead and glue your rear bulkhead in. Now this body is super thick, so getting that interior in and out is not the easiest task. I mean, it's, you can hear it. It's like, there we go. It's very, 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 very tight fit. But once you assemble that, like so, I'll let you take a good look at that when you're assembling yours. We'll hold it there. We'll hold it there. There. Pause the video when you're building if you're like, how the heck does this thing go together? You can see how it goes. And you'll be all set. So when you get that in there, you can see it's a beautifully tight fit. And it fits in there very nice and looks nice. Then you'll know where to glue that nice little bulkhead back there. You can get your model glue on it. Remove the interior once you know where this is supposed to be before that glue dries. You don't want to glue your interior in just yet till you get it painted, get the body painted, and then you can mate those two. But when you assemble that, make sure that the upper part, which would be what you maybe call a dashboard, I guess, and that scoop fits in right behind that groove. Then you know you've got it in the right location and you're all set. Now that I've done that, I can head over to paint.
Bye.
Mr. Norm's Supercharger funny car with the monster Hemi under the hood. All done. Very easy kit to build. No real problems at all. In fact, the only thing that keeps popping up, literally popping up, is the windshield. It fits in its groove, but the minute I apply any glue, I come back no matter what I do, and it shifts itself to one side a little bit. And I've removed it, put it back on, removed it, put it back on. I don't know what I'm doing. It clearly just sits in there without any glue. You could just press it in there. I think if I did it again, I would just lay the windshield in, put the future floor polish over it, and let that be the adhesive, because the Mod Podge is making it like slowly just glide to one side, and the body's not warped. The body sits perfectly straight. I don't know what it is. It's not the kit's fault. Clearly, I'm doing something, but that's the only thing if I had to pick out anything. Otherwise, the kit builds up easily. That interior pushes in nicely. We got that nice chassis on there. Everything looks awesome with the steering and the tachometer and the belt and the fire extinguisher, that big engine. We got the gold rear wheels. The headers look awesome coming out from underneath the body. It's even got the header supports on there, the fuel tanks, the decals, as you saw when I did the decals in this one, because I hadn't done a video with decals in a while. They laid down just fine. I probably didn't need to use any decal solvent, but I still do just to make sure everything soaks into the nooks and crannies, especially the large white stripe across the hood so that it sits across all the vents and wraps around the fenders gently. Then I brushed it with the future floor polish, since I haven't shown that on camera in a while, and all worked just fine. I like how it looks. I got my little support here so that I can later display it with the body up, and I'll have pictures of it both ways. I did use the split grill of the 69 Charger and the different taillights for the 69 Charger just for personal reasons, because it's a red Charger. I wanted to use that. Both grills are correct. Whether you have the solid grill or the split grill are correct. You can find pictures of both with the same logos on the side, just the different grill on the front. I suppose different years he campaigned it and stuff would be absolutely fine, and that's why they're on the decal sheet. Of course, like we showed you, you can also go ahead and use these and match the box art perfectly. I chose to use the split grill just because I have some reasons for doing that, personal reasons. I like the assembly. They give you all the optional wheels on there. I went with the wheels on the box art, and they look lovely with a little black wash and then mounted in. Everything is pretty sweet on this ride. I did enjoy it. Super easy. Thanks to Round 2 through Polar Lights sending this over for review. A nice build. I wouldn't have any issues with most people assembling this, aside from how tight that interior fits in. The chassis is fiddly. I think give yourself a few glue kits before you attack this one, but otherwise, you're really not going to have to struggle or fight. It's a fun build. Everyone loves the Chargers. They look tough even sitting still. And Mr. Norm's, I put pictures on the Facebook page for the workshop of the Mr. Norm's dealership and some of the cars they've come out with, and they always look amazing. As always, thanks for watching the workshop. I will link down in the description where you can get this on pre-order. Not quite available yet, but it will be available not too long in the future. Thanks to Round 2 Models. Thanks to all of you, the cool viewers. And coming up, Christmas will be here in a couple days. A perfect kind of a gift to get for yourself on pre-order. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.